Python 3.13 features something Python users have been anticipating for years now, a no-GIL or free-threaded version of Python. The Python interpreter has long had a component called the global interpreter lock, or GIL, that prevents a given object by being modified by more than one thread at a time. One big downside of the GIL is that Python's programs can't really use threading for CPU-based parallelism. For that, you have to resort to multiprocessing. But now, we have the first public builds of Python that don't need the GIL, and so they can run CPU-bound work at full speed on different threads. Let's take a look at how this works. When you first install Python 3.13, you're given an option, shown here, to download the free threaded binaries. If you install Python with this option selected, you get two instances of Python 3.13 in your system. On Windows, we can choose between those versions with the Py launcher. As you can see, we have a regular Python 3.13 version, and another one named Python 3.13.t. If we just launch Py 3.13, we get the regular build of Python, with the GIL included. But if we use Py 3.13t, we get the no-GIL build. That makes it easy to choose which build we want to use for a given program. Now, if you're inside a Python program and you want to find out if the GIL is available, you can use import sys and then use sys.isGILenabled. The leading underscore is important. Notice that this only works on Python 3.13. On other versions of Python, you're going to get an attribute error exception, so you will want to trap for that. So now comes the next question. How do we use the no-GIL build to make Python programs faster? Well, I'm going to start here with a program that was written with an earlier version of Python in mind to use parallelism. Previously, we had to use subprocessing, or the process pool system, to get true parallelism. And that had disadvantages, the biggest being that you had to spin up multiple instances of the Python interpreter. That cost memory and startup time, and it's slow to coordinate data between instances. This program uses a common abstraction for subprocessing, the process pool, to launch multiple instances of some CPU-expensive task. If we run it as is in Python 3.13 with the GIL, the whole thing runs in about 0.6 seconds. Now, let's swap in a thread pool and see what happens. Now everything takes much longer. Threading actually made things worse here. But what happens when we run the threaded version using the no-GIL build? The results are on a par with our multiprocessing version. In fact, they're usually slightly faster. So what's key here is that we're using Python's high-level abstractions for threading, the thread pool, to get the effects we need. And as long as you use the high-level abstractions for threading that Python provides, you should see an improvement in performance for CPU-bound activity. Things like network I/O, though, are not going to be any different. Now, several things are worth keeping in mind when you experiment with the free-threaded Python build. First, not everything is going to be faster. This is why the free-threaded build is delivered as a separate binary, so that you can test it in isolation and see how it behaves. It's still experimental. Two, if something wasn't thread-safe before, it's not magically going to be thread-safe now. If you're using locks or queues for thread safety, you still need to do that. And three, don't use the free-threaded build in production unless you really know what you're doing. But feel free to experiment with it, as experimenting will give you a leg up on how to use it well when and if it becomes a standard offering. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.